Is it clear, please? Everybody can see it?
Yes, I can see it.
Okay. Okay, I'm going to introduce myself. I am Mohammed Al-Maini. I did MSc in Pune University, India, microbiology, and I did my PhD in Leicester University, UK, in bioinformatic field. I'm working lecturer at Baghdad University. My topic is investigation the genomic variation of ST253 of Pseudomonas aeruginosa isolate. Okay, introduction. Pseudomonas aeruginosa is opportunistic pathogenic. Opportunistic pathogenic bacteria means it causes disease when the host resistance is low. And Pseudomonas aeruginosa is known famous bacteria to cause morbidity and mortality in cystic fibrosis. And morbidity means it causes disease in cystic fibrosis, while mortality, it's the death case related with this disease. Pseudomonas aeruginosa causes many nosocomial infection. And nosocomial infection means the infection exists in certain locations, such as hospital. And it causes infections such as skin or urinary tract or respiratory tract infection. And Pseudomonas aeruginosa is highly mutant pathogen. And the mutation leads to resist to antibiotic. Therefore, Pseudomonas aeruginosa resists many antibiotic because its ability to accumulate many mutation. The novelty of this work. The novelty of this work, analysis of genetic variation for inferring potential microevolution of the isolate and finding pattern and dynamic of variation in such region that have a role in adaptation of Pseudomonas aeruginosa with host strategy attack. Material and method. Comparative genome analysis was performed on next generation sequencing for 9 isolates. We collected the isolate, all they are belong to the same serotype, 253, because we are going to investigate the genomic variation on the level of microevolution. And we determine the genetic variation of the isolate by using genome comparator program. And the genome comparator program hosted in bacterial isolate genome sequence database. And this program is going to blast each gene in the reference genome, PA01, against each gene for the target isolate, our target isolate, and detect if the gene is variable or similar gene. If there is variability in the gene, if there is change in the genes or no, and if there is change in the nucleic acid or no. Of the gene. When we detect the variation using GC comparator, not all the genes that detected, they are real variable gene. Some genes are spurious variable gene. So we have to use some criteria to filter spurious variable gene. So those criteria are as the follows. Or first, the loci that had X signal in most of our isolate indicate the gene was absence. This is X signal. So those genes was filtered or excluded from the analysis. And this indicate that the gene was not sequenced because this technique, next generation sequencing or whole genome sequencing is going to do partial genome sequencing. So we have some genome that are not sequenced, so we have to exclude them from the analysis. Secondly, the loci that had more than one copy in the genome, which term paralogous loci. So as we see here in the table, this is the name of the gene, has 9 copies. So if genes has more than one copy in the genome, we have to exclude it from the analysis because we don't know the variation related with which gene from those 9 genes when we detect the variation. So we excluded from the analysis. Also, the variation was introduced at the gap at the start of end of the alignment. And this is an example alignment, the gap started at the alignment. This is not indel insertion deletion, because we know gap means there is indel insertion deletion within the genome. But when the gap start at the beginning or the end of the alignment, this does not revert to the indel. It means misalignment. So we have to exclude it from the analysis. Also, the variation located within SSR, simple sequence repeat. If the variation located within simple sequence repeat, we have to exclude this variation. And this is example, the variation located with the sequence, simple sequence repeat, A changed to C. And the sequence symbol repeat, the third target repeat means there is 9 or 8 C or a 9C, etc. So when the variation located within the symbol sequence repeat, we have to exclude it from the analysis. Finally, the truncated allele in multiple isolate, we have to exclude it from the analysis, which they give it I. I mean incomplete gene, mean the gene is not sequenced completely. Because the gene is not sequenced completely, we have to exclude it from the analysis. So when we look for a gene, we see I means this gene is incomplete. We have to exclude it from the analysis. And if the base pair, number of the base pair, 100, less than 100 base pair, we consider this as not gene, because the gene, the length of the gene more than 100 base pair, so we exclude it from the analysis. Also, we used SNAP program to detect synonymous and non-synonymous change. Synonymous change means changing DNA does not change to protein, while non-synonymous change, changing DNA lead to change of protein. And the non-synonymous change is important because changing DNA lead to change the protein, and changing a protein means escape immune system. NCBI, we used also NCBI conserved domain database for detecting if the variation located within the conserved domain. And as we know, the domain for the protein detects each domain, detect the function and the three dimension of the protein. And if the variation located within the domain, means this variation is important because this domain is responsible for the function and the three dimension structure of the protein. Also, we used Strito Encyclopedia of Gene on Genome to detect functional scheme and proportional effect of variation for each variable gene. Result and discussion. Detection the genome variation in the gene region of Pseudomonas aeruginosa isolate using GC program. We said when we used GC program, we found 342 genes. Overall, there were 342 genes. But when we exclude the Siberia's variable gene, the real variable gene were 222. And we exclude the Siberia's variable gene as follows. The incomplete or absent genes were 18, while more than one copy of the gene means paralogous loci 16. Variable due to mismatch at the end of the beginning of alignment 15 gene, and the variation located within the simple sequence repeat were 71, and all of those excluded from the analysis. The analysis of the type of variation for our isolate under the study. We have seen that most of the variation was detected due to one SNP. And most of the gene varied due to one SNP. And this is because we have done the variation on the level of microevolution. While we have seen little bit variation for genes caused by indel or multi-SNP or three SNP, etc. TIG was used to assign loci to functional group by different scheme. For the functional group, we have seen that the metabolism was the higher with 157 genes, comparable with other scheme. However, this analysis does not account for the total number of the gene within the genome. And because we have high number of the gene in the metabolism scheme, we have 2,443 genes responsible for the metabolism. We got high number of variable gene in the metabolism. So we have to count or to analyze proportional effect. Proportional effect means we have to divide the variable gene for each scheme on the total number of the genome on the gene for the genome for each scheme. When we detect the proportional effect, we have seen environmental information processing 0.1 more than the other schemes. And we got the environmental information processing genes higher than the other scheme. Environmental information processing genes means the genes that code for outer membrane protein. And because they are outer membrane protein, they are in direct contact with the immune system. And because they are direct contact with the immune system, they change their protein to escape immune system. Therefore, we got high variability in information processing comparable with other scheme. The genome variation was analyzed for synonymous change and non-synonymous change. And we have seen the non-synonymous change was higher than the synonymous change. And this indicates this variation is important, unimportant. Because as we mentioned before, non-synonymous change means changing the DNA lead to change the protein and escape immune system. Finally, we analyzed if the variation located within the conserved domain using NCBI conserved domain database. We detected 21 genes out of 31, the variation located within the conserved domain. And this is also means this significant result and important result because when the variation located within the conserved domains means this conserved domain responsible for function and three-dimensional structures of a protein. So this means this variation helped to escape immune system. Summary of main finding. Analysis of the genetic variation showed that there were 222 variable gene, real variable gene, out of 5,572 loci. The single nucleotide polymorphism was higher comparable with other type of variation, as we saw, because we did our analysis on level of microevolution. The proportional effect of functional scheme revealed that environmental information processing gene were higher comparable with other scheme, as we said, because environmental information processing means the genes that code for outer membrane protein. And because they are outer membrane protein, they are in direct contact with the immune system. And because they are in direct contact with the immune system, so they varied to escape immune system. Non-synonymous change was higher than comparable with synonymous change, and non-synonymous change, as we said, changing the DNA lead to change protein and escape immune system. Finally, all the variation located within the conserved domains means this is good indicator. Those variation help those bacteria, Pseudomonas aeruginosa, to escape immune system. Thank you for your listening. Is there any question, please?